more teachers on the platform, students on the YouTube channel. We're going live on YouTube. It's a beautiful morning, everyone, after such a Easter break, an unusual one, where we were in lockdown for some period. I hope that you are all feeling good and you are in a frame of mind for resumption of work. I know it has been hard for some time, but I know that with God, all things are possible. So, you know, as usual, we're going to start the morning with some music and then we get ready for guest speaker. All right, it's a good morning, everyone. Here in Claremont, St. Anne, it's sunny on the outside. Don't know what is happening in your neck of the woods, but I hope you are all well, all rested, and ready to move ahead in your life's journey. You know that we are on life's journey. Each of us have our own purpose, and we just have to keep trusting God in the process, trusting in him such a way that we can achieve that we set our mind to. And this morning, I have with us sharing his thoughts, his illness hall, a past student of Ferncourt High School. He graduated in 2010. Time moving so fast, oh my gosh. He was one of the valedictorians at the school leaving ceremony. He then moved on to the Monique College, where he pursued his diploma in teaching, then to IUC for his Bachelor of Education. He also received his Bachelor of Arts at the Queen's University in Canada, Master's of Education from the University of Western Ontario. He taught for 5 years at the elementary level. He has also been an instructor in the Faculty of Education at the University of Regina and Memorial University of Newfoundland, founder of Teach Solutions. He's also a father of 2 children. Now he's currently the principal of Sam Pudler Elementary School and correctional officer with the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. I know it's a lot, but I know that he will deliver as expected. So as I'm getting him to come on, let me give good morning, Ilonis.
Good morning, Mr. T, and good morning to everyone online. Thank you for having me another time to share with you. I know it's probably a lot warmer where you are than where I am at right now. It's just a little over 5 degrees. So it's nice. And it's raining. So it's definitely not a good day for us, this neck of the woods.
All right, then. So it's over to you now.
Right. So I'm going to be sharing my page so where I can speak off. So speak from. So you guys won't be seeing me a lot. So on the first slide here, before I go into that, thank you, Mr. T, again for the warm welcome. And I am no stranger to Ferncourt, as you all know. I see many familiar names on the chat. And so I am definitely one of the beneficiaries of the good work that the teachers at Ferncourt has put in over the years. Mr. T, can you see my page now?
Yes, I'm seeing it.
Okay, awesome. So on our first slide here, I have just a little story that we see happen almost every day. And as children move from one stage of their lives to another, from the creeping stage and then slowly into the walking stage, we often see many stumbles, many pitfalls, but at no time did they just give up and quit and say, well, this is just not for me. They get up and they get themselves together and they try again. And I always make this analogy comparable to riding a bicycle. And I said, if we are learning to ride a bicycle and we don't get it the first time, so we keep on have to try and try and try again until we perfect that skill. And so that's something that I have taken personally into my own life. And that's something that I have definitely applied to my own existence. And so if I fail at something, then I just don't give up. I get myself together and I press on. So this morning, I want to share with you about persistence. And I am going to speak from the scripture, Luke 18, verses 1-8. And he told them a parable of the effect that they would ought always to pray and not lose heart. He said, in a certain city, there was a judge who neither feared God nor respected man. And there was a widow that the city who kept coming to him and saying, give me justice against my adversary. For a while he refused, but afterwards he said to himself, though I neither fear God nor respect man, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will give her justice so that she will not beat me down by her continual coming. And the Lord said, hear what the unrighteous judge says. And will not God give justice to his elect, who cry to him day and night? Will he delay long over them? I tell you, he will give justice to them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? In this parable, a widow who was not just poor, but was also powerless and weak, according to the scriptures, was seen as being nagging to this judge who, in those days, was a powerful person. And in those days as well, it was an obligation for people holding such position, such as a judge, to act on behalf of the poor and the weak. We've seen the word that the judge was very reluctant to assist in this poor widow. But did she give up? No, she was persistent with her request. As it says in the word, we are to pray always not to lose heart. This parable is not just about a poor widow, but it is one that teaches us as servant of God to preserve in our faith against all adversaries. And I know, for example, most of the students who are probably joining in from YouTube, we all go through difficulties in our lives. Right now, I know it's probably very difficult for students who are coping with the online learning situation and probably do not have the relevant resources to assist with that. There are SBAs going on, exams are coming up, and you need to prepare. And also the teachers who have to be finding creative ways of getting you ready for those exams. And all of those are difficulties or challenges that we are facing, that you are facing, but we can't give up. And that's what the scripture is talking about. We have to find the willpower, we have to find the drive, and we have to press along. And even those who will come across will be like the judge. For example, for you students, sometimes the teachers are going to be frustrated with you because you're not responding in a timely manner. And for the teachers, sometimes we feel like the system is against us because they are not providing the resources that we need to do our daily duties. But what the scripture is saying to us this morning is that even if we are acting in the way of the judge, then we also have to remember that there is higher power. And in the same way, the Lord was able to grant that desire of the poor widow, is the same way we'll grant our desire, even when we face these obstacles in our lives. And there are other scriptures in the Bible where we have seen persistence came out. For example, in James, who was also a servant of God, and he too met different trials and different tribulations. But one of the things that caused James to be a winner was that he was able to be persistent and he was able to carry on. And so I know from my own experience that students of Fern Court are winners. And so as winners, I expect you to win. And it's not going to be smooth sailing, no matter where you are, no matter where you go. But if we find ways to push on and not give up and pray about it, because that's what the scripture is telling us, is that we have to pray. We have to keep faith. Even when it seems that like we are not getting anywhere, we still have to find that faith and that drive to push on. There is a saying that says, Rome was not built in a day. And that again talks about persistence. So the ones that you want in your exams, they are not going to come overnight from just studying one day and then you will get a one. Some of us are genius and it will happen. But that's not for everybody. And so my encouragement to you is that You have to find a way or a method, something that works for you in this time, because I know it's not easy. I know it's not an easy task for you right now, especially with the online schooling situation that is going on. But I know too that if you persist and if you keep trying at it and if you seek help and if you have that faith in God, then he will make a way and he will see you through it. There's another saying that says the only thing that lasts forever is good salvation. And so even though this journey of you preparing for your exams or the teachers who are preparing you for the exams seems endless, it is only for a matter of time. And so while it lasts, I am encouraging you to make the best of it. Yesterday, I was talking to a few students that I've taught many years ago in Jamaica, probably 7 or 8 years ago in Jamaica. And they too were sharing experiences with me where they were having difficulties with different subjects preparing for the CSEC exam, because my first students that I taught in Jamaica are also sitting CSEC this year. And one of the things that I taught them back then was the gem about labor for learning. And those are things that I too have learned while I was a student, not just at Ferncourt, but prior to Ferncourt and even after Ferncourt. And even though those might be seen as just simply saying, and we sometimes get annoyed by repeating them through rote learning, I have come to realize in my own life that they add so much value to my own existence. And so I encourage you guys as well to take heed to those small sayings. No matter how simple they sound, they come with a lot of value. And so take heed to them. So even in the heights by great men, reached and kept, were not attained by sudden flight, but they, while their companions slept, were toiling upwards through the night. Again, it is the persistence that is within us that causes us to be the winners that we are. We might not always have it together. We might not always see the prize at the end, but through the persistence and through the perseverance that is within us, then we will always get to that place of success. And I want to end today with something that I have always used when I am talking to my staff or to my students. And in this image, there is one picture where this guy is further away from the prize, and this one is very close to getting there. And had he known that he was this close to reaching his target or to find what he was looking for, then I don't think that he would have given up. And so I want to encourage you guys today that you should never lose sight of the fact that you are on a path, you are on a journey, and you have to keep your eyes on the prize at the end. It's not always good teachers. It's not always the best place that we want to be. I know, especially on the Monday morning, sometimes we want to sleep in. But then when we think about the lives that we have to impact on a daily basis, then we find that zeal and zest and we put our best foot forward. And students, it's the same thing for you. I know it's not always easy to wake up on a Monday morning. It's not always easy to listen to our monotone voices as teachers. It's not always easy for us to find the intrinsic motivation, the motivation from within us to get our work done. But I encourage you that you are closer to your dream than you were yesterday. So I hope this very brief presentation will shed some light on the value of persistence, especially in this very difficult time. And so I want to leave with you a quick word of prayer, which I don't do very regularly in public, but for the sake of Fern Court and the blessings that Fern Court have given me, I don't mind sharing that grace with you. And I think the Lord has sent me to share the word with you. And so I will definitely. Father Lord, thank you for this day. It's a brand new day. It's a brand new time. And it's a very difficult time for all of us. Thank you for the opportunity to connect with those that are going through the same journey that I once was a part of. Thank you, O God, for the teachers that you have given the strength to persist and to persevere during these difficult times and for the many years. Thank you for helping them and for guiding them to guide me and for giving them the continuous strength to guide many others that came after me. Thank you for the leader of the school. Thank you for the staff, the ancillary staff, academic staff, cooking staff, and all members of the Fern Court family. Dear God, we know that the students are going through a very difficult time, whether it's through family situations, the pandemic has not helped any at all. And we know that the exams pressure sometimes interfere with their mental state. Thank you for the guidance that you have given them thus far. And I pray, oh God, that you will give them the wisdom, the courage, and the understanding that if they persist, if they pray, and if they seek for you, God, through prayer, then you will guide them and you will help them to persevere. It is a difficult time for them, oh God. And I know from my own experience that I had to come to you and I had to ask you for the strength and the guidance as I carried on through that journey of my life. And God, in the same way you came through for me, I pray that you would come through for these youngsters as well. Bless them, oh God, touch them, guide their parents, oh God, and let them understand that even in the midst of all their adversaries, you are still God and that you will and you can come through for them. For these and other mercies we ask, in your most obedient name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Mr. T.
Amen, amen. That was a good prayer. I mean, you probably need to do it more often, but it was good, good, good. Thank you, Ernest, for sharing the word with us this morning. This month in April, we're focusing on persistence. So that's why you hear Ernest talking about being persistent and so forth. And he has reminded us of some stuff that we have the power, we have the willpower to press on. Depends on what is happening all around us. We have to just press on. Press along, saints. Press along. I remember that song. He reminded us also that we are winners. It's not going to be a smooth sailing at times, but we just have to remember that we are winners. We also must make the best of the opportunities available because you never know how close you are on achieving your dreams. Thank you, Ernest, for the word. Trust me, I'm going to get you back at some other point because, trust me, you did well.
I see somebody in the chat window, Winston Seymour. Is he a teacher at the school?
Yes, he's here with us now.
Oh, I taught him in grade 6.
Oh, man. All right. So, yes, he's here with us now. So, see?
Okay, wonderful.
Good, good. So, all your work, as you see, come to fruition. But I know where you are, as I said, it's cool and so forth, but that's a good thing about technology, able to connect for different persons all across the world, which we'll continue to utilize as we continue our educational journey. Thank you again.
All right, thanks, Sir Thomas. And good morning again to all the teachers at Fern Court and all the students. And teachers, it's good to connect with you and I can't wait to come down there physically to connect with you guys.
All right, thank you. Because I think probably you might have other tasks to do.
So. I do.
All right, so thanks again.
All right.
Good, bye. Good. All right, good. All right, students and our teachers on the different platforms, it's good that you're back with us for another day, another working week. I know it's bit uncertainty as it relates to the face-to-face learning. But as I advise the grade 11 students and the sixth form student that we just need to monitor media for further information, We will still proceed with our grade 10 students doing their online online examinations, right? So I want grade 10 students to still be prepared, but the other students, grade 7 to 9 and grade 11, 12, 13, our virtual school starts today. And also the grade 10, because I think their exam starts tomorrow. So I want you all to be mindful. Remember, there's hope. Hope in the name of the Lord. We cannot give up. We cannot give up. So we just simply have to remain focused and put all hands on deck as we work together through this time of uncertainty. Let's get ready for the playing of the national anthem.
God and all mankind, I pledge the love and loyalty of my heart,
the wisdom and courage of my mind,
the strength and vigor of my body,
the service of my fellow citizens.
I promise to stand up for justice,
brotherhood, and peace.
Work diligently and creatively,
think generously and honestly,
so that Jamaica may
increasing beauty,
fellowship and prosperity,
and play her part in advancing the welfare
of the whole human race.
All right, so it's the end of our General Assembly for this morning, April 12, 2021. We now resume regular classes as timetable. You will see me back on Friday with another past student sharing the word with you. Have a wonderful day, everyone, and a productive week.